Good morning, SY students. Today we study the point logarithmic decrement in damped oscillations. Okay? In last lecture, we have studied special cases, and there are three cases. Case first, in which we have got overdamped motion. In case second, we have got critically damped motion. And in third case, where we consider the damping force is less than restoring force, and in that case we have got the oscillatory motion. Okay, now here we consider the point logarithmic decrement. That means in the equation of damped oscillation, the amplitude always decreases with time. As time increases, amplitude decreases exponentially, that means logarithmically. So here we consider the point logarithmic decrement. Now you know the equation of damped oscillator, and it is given that is x equal to a e raised to minus rt upon tau sm sin of pt plus theta. This equation we have obtained in first lecture. Okay, so this is the equation of damped oscillator which compounds damping oscillations. Okay, now in this equation, the amplitude a e raised to minus rt upon tau sm decreases with time, and it decreases exponentially. Okay, so after some time or after long time, oscillator comes to the its equilibrium position. Okay, so this equation x equal to a e raised to minus rt upon tau sm sin of pt plus theta, in which this p is the angular frequency, okay, and theta is the phase angle. Now this term, that is a e raised to minus rt upon tau sm, is the amplitude, and this amplitude decreases with time. Okay, now next we consider that the oscillation will be start from mid position. Then here we have shown that amplitude, successive amplitudes a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, a6 and so on. When we consider oscillation start from mid position, then when we plot the graph of displacement versus time, then the amplitude decreases continuously with time, and this decrease in amplitude with time is called exponential decay of amplitude. So it is called as the logarithmic decrement. Okay, here amplitude start from mid position and it continuously decreases with time. Okay, so next we consider successive amplitudes, that is a1, a2, a3, a4 and so on. Then we consider period of oscillation, that is capital T is the period of oscillation. Okay, then we have to measure first amplitude in time t. That means we have to measure first amplitude a1 in time t, and this first amplitude is given by equation a1 equal to e raised to minus rt upon tau sm. So we have to measure only amplitude, that is a1 equal to e raised to minus rt upon tau sm, and this amplitude we measure in terms of exponential decay. So we write here, that is a1 equal to a e raised to minus rt upon twice m in this form. Okay, then next amplitude is measured in time, that is a2 equal to a e raised to minus r upon twice m in bracket t plus t by 2, that is for next half cycle. Okay, then third amplitude is measured in time a3 equal to a e raised to minus r upon twice m in bracket t plus t by 2. Okay, then next amplitude write a e raised to minus r upon twice m t plus t. Okay, t plus t. Then a4 amplitude write a4 equal to a e raised to minus r upon twice m in bracket t plus 3 t by 2. Okay, t plus 3 t by 2 and so on. So this is equation first, equation second, equation third and equation fourth. Okay, then we take ratio of successive amplitudes, right? So in order to write ratio of successive amplitudes, we have to take the ratio of a1 by a2, then a2 by a3, a3 by a4 and so on, right? Then I will write the ratio of successive amplitudes. Therefore, write here a1 by a2 equal to, write a1 here, a raised to minus rt upon twice m, a raised to minus rt upon twice m divided by a raised to minus r upon twice m into t plus t by 2. Okay, so we simplify this equation. Next term right here, a get cancelled, so right here e raised to minus rt upon twice m divided by, right here, e raised to minus rt upon twice m plus rt upon minus rt upon 4m, right here, e raised to minus rt upon twice m into e raised to minus r capital T upon this 4m. Okay, rt upon 4m with negative sign. Okay, so this term get cancelled and we take this term to upper side. Okay, therefore we get a1 by a2, that is the ratio of successive amplitudes, equal to e raised to rt upon 4m. Okay, then we take the ratio e2 by a3. Therefore, a2 by a3 equal to, write a2 here, that is a e raised to minus r upon twice m in bracket t plus t by 2, right? And then we write the value of a3. The value of a3 is a e raised to minus r upon twice m in bracket t plus t. So write here, a e raised to minus r upon twice m in bracket t plus t. Okay, so we simplify this. We write here a get cancelled and we write e raised to minus rt upon twice m into e raised to minus rt capital T upon 4m divided by, right here, e. Okay, then in denominator we write here e raised to minus rt upon twice m into e raised to minus rt upon, that is twice m. Okay, so this term get cancelled, and when we take this term to numerator, then we got this plus. So this value will get equal to e raised to rt upon 4m. In this way, when we take the ratio of next amplitudes, that is a3 by a4, then we will get the same ratio e raised to rt upon 4m. Okay, so when we take the next ratio, that is a3 upon a4, that is we will get e raised to rt upon again 4m. So here the ratio of successive amplitude is always equal to e raised to rt upon 4m. Then we write here the ratio of successive amplitude, that is a1 by a2 equal to a2 by a3 equal to a3 by a4, that is equal to e raised to rt upon 4m. Right? So this ratio e raised to rt upon 4m is always constant. Right? So we take the log ln of this side, therefore write ln of a1 by a2 equal to ln of a2 by a3 equal to ln of a3 by a4, that is equal to rt upon 4m. Okay, is equal to rt upon 4m. So this ratio, that means ratio of successive amplitude, is equal to rt upon 4m, and it is constant. Okay, so this rt upon 4m is equal to constant, and it is denoted by letter lambda. Therefore we write here lambda equal to rt upon 4m, and this is called as the logarithmic decrement. So lambda is called as the logarithmic decrement, and it is constant and has value rt upon 4m. So we define the logarithmic decrement. The logarithmic decrement is the natural logarithm of ratio of successive amplitude. It is the natural logarithm of ratio of successive amplitude is called as the logarithmic decrement. Okay, so this is the our final equation, lambda equal to rt upon 4m. So this is the end of this point. So thanks to all.